Keep your eyes open for a good tea shop. Always happy to try a new blend. Good find, cohort.
You trespass here!
What is the meaning of this interruption? Why have you contacted me? This is Abner Tharn. The Master and I are very busy. This had better be important. Wait a moment. I don't know your face. Identify yourself immediately. Yes, your report, you insipid twit. What, did you contact me by accident? Well, out with it. I don't have all day. Your disguise is terrible, by the way. You look like a character from a bad adventure novel. Are they? I didn't think that Redguard Hasbeen had a single friend left. Not in this world, at any rate. Never fear. Sai Sahan is safely locked away. Even if they were to discover his location, attempting a rescue would be suicidal. Of course I do. But I'm not in the habit of revealing vital secrets to insipid lackeys. Now be gone. And if you contact me again without good reason, I shall contact your cell commander and have you properly thrashed for your ineptitude.
This one works a special kind of alchemy, theft to gold. What may I...
Let's get it done. building up a staff. Good thinking.
You've returned. What have you found?
Abnathan shows his face again. I get the sense that he might have a larger part to play in the coming events, but for good or ill, I cannot say.
Leave the orb with me.
I shall be able to use it to locate Sai Sahan.
Hold a moment. Come here. We need to talk.
I heard you and the Prophet talking about Abnathan. Didn't the Prophet tell you the story of the five companions? I don't know where to start. There's so much to tell. We were chosen by Emperor Varan to join him on a quest to recover a lost artifact called the Amulet of Kings. The five included Varan, myself, a Red Guard named Sai Sahan, Abnathan, and the traitor, Manimarco. You only know him as the man who killed you and stole your soul. But back then, he was Emperor Varan's most trusted advisor. It was Menemarco who convinced Varan to search for the Amulet of Kings. Varan wasn't a true dragonborn emperor. He didn't share Alessia's bloodline. Menemarco said the amulet could change all that. He said he could use it to perform a ritual that would turn Varan into a true dragonborn. It took us more than 2 years, but we finally recovered the amulet and returned to Cyrodiil to perform the ritual. Menemarchos set us up. The ritual caused a violent explosion of magical energy. We lost Varen. Sysahan and I were declared outlaws. Menemarchos convinced the Elder Council to recognize Abner Tharn's daughter Clivia as Empress Regent, but Menemarchos was the true power behind the throne. Sysahan and I went into hiding. There was a bounty on our heads. Well, the legend says that the Dragonfires were created from the blood of Akatosh and given to Saint Alessia. When a new emperor is crowned, they're supposed to relight them to prove that they're a true heir of Alessia, one of the Dragonborn. It took us more than 2 years, but we finally recovered the amulet and returned to Cyrodiil to perform the ritual. Abner Tharn is Grand Chancellor of the Elder Council and chief advisor to his daughter, the Empress Regent. He is also Menemarchos' toady. Tharn's first loyalty is to his family and the Empire, and he's a ruthless bastard when it comes to defending them. The Worm Cult obviously doesn't share those loyalties. Tharn would never trust them, but he's too much of a coward to betray them. Maybe. But what could we offer him? He's already got more gold than the gods themselves. I know it's a lot to take in. We'll talk more later. In the meantime, I'll keep an eye on the Prophet. Hopefully that orb will help him find out where Sysahan is being held. Once we know that, we can plan our next move.
I'm here, and I'm feeling feisty.
The fog has lifted, Vested. The path before us has been revealed. It is both dark and twisted. Come to the harborage. We have an unexpected guest who demands your presence. We have an unexpected guest, Vestige. My attempts to use the Orb of Discourse to locate Sai Sahan did not meet with success, so I decided to try a more direct approach. I use it as it was intended, and contacted Abnathan. He admits that he knows Sai Sahan's location, but he will not reveal it. He demands to speak with you directly.
We meet again, Vestige. I wish to speak with you on a matter of some urgency. Menemarco and his vile master have dark and terrible plans for this world. If you wish to stop them, you need to find the Amulet of Kings. But to find the amulet, you must first locate Sai Sahan.
Of course I do.
And I might be willing to share that information. For a price. If Menemarco learns that we've spoken, he'll have me executed. I'm a danger to him. I know too much. Therefore I, Abnathan, Chancellor of the Elder Council, Overlord of Nibonet, formally request asylum. Do I look to be in a mirthful mood? There comes a point when even a patriot's loyalty is stretched too far, when the things he has done, and has seen done, become too much to bear. Would that I could. As it happens, I find myself to be somewhat of a prisoner, in dire need of rescue. My proposal is this. If you retrieve me from Menemarco's fortress and grant me asylum, I will give you Sai Sahan's location in return. You can't. And you'd be a fool to trust me completely. But the facts remain, you need me if you wish to find Sai Sahan, and I must keep my head if I am to ensure the continuance of the Empire. Neither of us has a choice.
Farn is quite correct. We have little choice in the matter.
You can't be serious. How can we possibly trust him?
As our visitor so eloquently pointed out, we cannot. But if we are to locate Sai Sahan, we must do this. Go with the Vestige, Lyris. Rescue Tharn. Give him the chance to redeem himself. He may surprise you.
You appear to have arrived in the Wretched Squalor, a shantytown of soul-shriven outside Menemarco's castle. As luck would have it, Menemarco is away on some errand for the Daedric Prince. The castle garrison is not on alert, so you should only encounter a token defense. The main gate is sealed, but there are undoubtedly other routes one might take. You're the hero, aren't you? Improvise.
What a skeever. Improvise, he says. I can't believe we're risking our lives to rescue that skeeving horker. Subtlety and stealth. Let's not bring the entire castle guard down on our heads. And didn't he say this was a town of soul shriven? Maybe we can find one who knows his way around. Try to be inconspicuous. We just got free of this place. The last thing we need is to get recaptured.
What do you want? Why are you bothering me? Go away, or I'll call the guards. They'll probably take me too. Just go! Leave me alone!
Who are you? You don't look shriven. Are you one of those worm cult bastards? That's easy. All you've got to do is get captured, killed, and stuffed into a soul gem like yesterday's laundry. If you're serious, Cadwell can probably get you in. Might be too late, though. They just chased him into the guardhouse.
Why am I not surprised to find Cadwell here? He certainly does get around.
What are you doing here? Intruders!
I say, jolly good timing. Lyris enchanted, as always. And you're looking fit for someone, so how can I put it? Deficient in the soul department? Wherever the forces of evil prey upon the innocent, wherever souls are stolen and bodies shriven, wherever a people cry out for justice, there goest I. I mean, this whole eternal servitude business is rather nasty, don't you agree? Dibella's Garters, why? Lovely grounds, no question, but it's positively brimming with angry cultists carrying rather large weapons. I see. A rescue, is it? Well, that's a different kettle of fish, isn't it? There is a cistern that drains into the waterway. The door is locked, but that's not stopped me before. Why don't you meet me there, and we'll see what's what?
That might be our best chance to get inside. Leave it to the Daedra to fill a cave with bones and muck.
You keep up nicely. I can't abide dawdlers. This whole bloody castle sits on top of an ocean of unstable oblivion, what's it? The Daedra use pipes to control the flow of it all, and it comes out as steam. Well, most of the doors in here are sealed with pressure from that steam. It's all rather complicated. But in a nutshell, if I can tamper with the pipes, we can open the doors to the inner keep, and you can slip inside. Well, I could handle the tinkering, but you'll have to keep the beasties off me. It will be quite a romp. Are you game? Onward! Ha-ha!
Tentacles. I'm glad that's done. Thank you.
for tea, then.
Don't worry, this will get you inside with a minimum of fuss. One more after this one. This should do it. There you are. Quick as you please. There's even time for tea. A pleasure, thinking nothing of it. The merest trifle, truly. You'll find this Tharn fellow at the top of the Tower of Bones. You'll need to make your way through the Keep's Heart to get to it, but it's not terribly far. I understand the King of Worms has set him to the task of inspecting the soul gems that find their way into the castle. Which is to say, well, all of them. You'll see crates of the things scattered around the premises. Indeed? Well, I might just take you up on that. But safety first. I'll stay here for the nonce and make sure nothing comes to bugger up our little adventure from behind.
Sir Cadwell came through again. That crazy knight is starting to grow on me. Should I be worried?
No, no, hear me out. How many Tharns does it take to rule an empire?
Dullard! You! Hurry up! The worms are on the move!
There you are. I was beginning to think you were captured. We've a bit of a problem, I'm afraid. The door at the top of the tower has sealed with a warded barrier. I've seen the worms use similar sorceries before. It will sear you to ash if you touch it. Here's a thought. The flesh Atronachs that patrol the castle halls are assembled in a laboratory very close to the warded door. If you created your own Atronach, it would be bound to obey you. You could force it to smash through the barrier. It's a simple process. A child of five could do it. Unfortunately, we don't have a child of five, so I'll be forced to walk you through it. You'll need some good-sized chunks of flesh. Take them to the laboratory, and I'll contact you there.
It takes a lot to make me ill, but this is getting there.
Ah!
most glamorous task, is it? Freezing in here. At least that means the body parts won't smell as bad.
The fate is sealed.
Strike now.
I'm not going near the city butcher for a while, I'll tell you that much.
Not very big, is it? Oh well. Now, cast the ritual from the book. Ha! We'll make a necromancer of you yet. You're not far now. Through the door and to the summit.
Oh.
Begone, insufferable worms. I'm working as fast as I can.
There he is. Looks like they've got him under guard.
So, we meet in person at long last. You look taller in your projection. And not a moment too soon. If I had to inspect one more bloody soul gem, I'd have thrown myself from the tower. A fair question. I know things. Things that can help you. Here's a bit to whet your appetite. Menemarco isn't doing any of this to serve Molag Bal. His ultimate plan is to out-scheme the God of Schemes and to replace him. The Amulet of Kings is the key to everything. Why do you think he kidnapped Sai Sahan? He's torturing him, trying to get him to reveal the amulet's hiding place. Precisely. With the amulet at his command, Menemarco believes he can trap Molag Bal's essence and absorb his power. He seeks to become a god himself. I'd love to discuss this further, but this is hardly the place. Get me to a safe haven and I will tell you the rest. That was our agreement.
Now, Tharn. No telling my secrets. Go to your room, Abner. I will deal with you shortly. Ah, dear Lyris. Your old position at the Foundry is still available. We'll even give you your own set of unbreakable chains. And you, the thorn in my side, the pebble in my shoe. How strong are you? Shall we test your weakness? Infuriating. The process drains the energy from most victims, yet you keep fighting! Strength surprises me. But how much more can you take, I wonder?
They want to fight, do they?
Dare attack the Chancellor of the Elder Council. His power wanes, Vestige. Strike him down while his attentions are on me.
How dare you betray me, Tharn? Your suffering will be legendary.
He will not remain discorporated for long. His consciousness will be adrift for a few moments, but that is all. Because Menemarco has delusions of godhood. He cares nothing for the Empire. He seeks only power. I've never done battle with him before. He's far more powerful than I imagined. Ah, well. Too late for regrets. In for a beanstalk. First things first. We need to get out of here alive. We certainly can't go back the way you came in. I'd imagine they're swarming the grounds already. There's a refuse chute further down the path. It's a bit of a drop, but we'll probably survive.
You must be the ugliest princess ever rescued from a tower, Tharn.
I'm shocked your lack of education and repeated blows to the head haven't dulled your wit, Titanborn.
Hello again! Need a way out? I'll have that open in just a moment. Arcay Preservus, you're as battered and bruised as a peach in a sack of rocks. Bit of the old derring do, was it? No matter. You'll be needing an escape route, no doubt. Well, it's what I do, quite honestly. We should probably hurry it up. The entire castle is as bristly as a sack of sewing needles after all that noise. Come with you? You mean leave Cold Harbor? Well, I don't know. It's been a very long time since I've seen the world I left behind. Do you think it's wise? Well, that's settled then. And after all, you do need someone to lead you out of here. Onward! Into the chute, come on!
Quickly! I've opened another portal, hurry!
My estates, my titles, my own life, it's all forfeit now. All in the name of preserving the Empire. I swear by all the gods, Menemarku will pay dearly for this. Of course. I am Abner Tharn. It will take more than a few brainless cultists to rattle these old bones. Now then, where were we? Ah, yes. Truth be told, I don't know the precise location, but I do know that he is Manimarco's prisoner, and that the King of Worms is trying to pry the location of the amulet from him. Now, before you lose your temper, let me clarify. I don't know precisely where he is, but I can find out. I'll just need a little time.
What? You son of a bitch!
Are you insane? Get away from me, you brutish she-troll!
Lyris, stand down.
He's done nothing but lie to us from the beginning. I don't care what he says. He'll always be Menemarco's toady.
Please. Menemarco wants me dead. Did I pretend to capitulate to him? Yes, I did. Do you have any idea how many lives I saved by doing so?
The only thing you saved was your holdings in your own hide, you pompous ass!
Enough. Abner had no choice, Lyris. And we are guilty of our own deceit, are we not? The time has come for the Vestige to know the truth.
What's this? The Vestige doesn't know? Oh, this is rich.
Sire, don't.
Vestige, until now, you've only known me as the Prophet. But that is not my true name. I am Verin Aquilarius.
Our fallen emperor, in the tattered robes of a moth priest. Blind as a newborn kitten.
I am sorry I deceived you, Vestige. You're angry. It is to be expected. I was once, but no more.
My name is Baron Aquilarius. In truth, I feared you'd kill me where I stood if you knew who I was. You certainly wouldn't have allied with us so readily. I caused this, all of this. If Molag Bal destroys this world, the blame will be mine and mine alone. You must not blame Lyris. She did as I instructed. She's my sworn protector, but she is also your ally. You have my solemn promise, Vestige. When this is over, if you still judge me harshly, you can end my life. I will offer no resistance. We must find Sysahan. Everything depends on that. In this matter, nothing. Abra and I must confer. We will contact you again when we have more information. I did not foresee Abner's defection, but I welcome it. Manamarco fears him, and with good reason. He can help us. I feel certain of it.